And then another lovely incident took place when the pianist, the famous Russian pianist, Rachmaninoff, came in with his wife. And his wife was dressed in black, and of course he had a black suit on. And I just didn't get enough courage up to walk over and disturb them. They were talking to each other and so on. And what we did was we tried to play music that was fit for a man sitting of that caliber in the room. And eventually they finished their meal and they got up and went out. Now, outside the dining room, there was a sitting room with Chesterfields and the beautiful seats and so on. And he evidently left his wife sitting in one of the... And he came back in the room, walked all the way from the door, and stood in front of us, and with his long arms, did a deep bow, and got up, turned around, and walked out. Well, I couldn't hold back the tears. That was the most amazing, amazing, touching thing that a human being could do.
The Royal York was one of a string of Canadian Pacific hotels across the country. CPR in the 1920s and 30s was also one of Canada's most important cultural forces. They produced radio programs, engaged musicians and singers for their hotels, and sponsored music festivals. It was because of the CPR that both Murray Adaskin and the New Brunswick-born soprano Frances James came to share a stage at the Banff Springs Hotel.
From the Mount Stephen Hall in the Banff Springs Hotel, a lovely theme of his own composition introduces another Sunday evening musicale by Murray Adaskin and his concert trio, with the lyric soprano voice of Frances James as assisting artist. The trio is composed of Louis Creerar, pianist, Philip Spivak, cellist, and Murray Adaskin, violinist.
I was sent out to play with a trio. It would be in the very early 30s. And we gave a concert every evening. And there were two singers at the hotel, Frances James and a male singer. The first time I heard her sing, I was just overwhelmed by it. It was so beautiful and so perfect. I just really was very deeply moved by it. And that's how I gradually got to know her, and she got to know me.
Frances James and Murray Adaskin married in the year they met, 1931. They often performed together. Perhaps most memorably in 1939, before King George VI and Queen Elizabeth. As a leader and oratorio singer, and as a pioneer singer of the work of 20th century Canadian composers, Frances James became one of the country's most familiar voices. Their musical lives were intertwined until her death in 1988. But while Frances James was developing artistically, Murray Adaskin began to feel constrained by the life of the performer. He wanted to be more than a violinist.
I wanted to be a composer. And, of course, I had absolutely no knowledge of how you write music. And once I decided, I'm going to write a string quartet. Ha ha. I got as far as maybe two pages, and that started me off. Then I decided to study with John Weinzweig, who was a marvelous teacher, a really great teacher. John Weinzweig was wonderful in explaining forms, all the different forms in music, and how one worked at them and developed them and so on. And finally the time came, he said, now you're a violinist, and of course I was a professional violinist at that time. Why don't you write a violin sonata for yourself? And that's how I wrote my first sonata, which is now on a CD with the first violinist of the Lafayette Quartet and her mother recorded it. It's a very lovely recording. And that was my first piece.